Hello, everyone. Welcome to our live stream today. It is Friday, August 18th, 11 a.m. Eastern Time. I'm super excited to be here today and talk to you about GA4 reports regarding LinkedIn paid ads. Hopefully, today's session is going to be useful to you. I'm super excited to start sharing how we can do this in a quick and effective way. So, this is what we will be discussing today. Step number one, LinkedIn. Where are your ads and how to export your report? Step number two, reviewing your data and making sure that it has everything that you need to set yourself up for success. Step number three, UTM tags. Why are they needed and why they're super, super important? Step number four, how to simplify your work and align campaign names and other data. And step number five, how do we import our LinkedIn reports into GA4 with a click so that we can get all the information we need in one place? Okay. Let's get started. First, we're going to go into LinkedIn. So this is my campaign manager in LinkedIn. As you can see, I have been running 4 different campaigns, and these campaigns essentially promoted our brand. So if I click on one of those, for example, I will be able to see more details about the different variations of my creatives, about my cost and performance of every individual ad, etc. If I click on the creative itself, I'm actually going to be able to see my ad and how it performs. Actually, how it performs is going to be available in my ad manager, but I can see actually my ad here. Okay, so what I need to do now is I want to export my entire data. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click here to select all of my campaigns, and then I'm going to hit export. When I export here, I will select my campaign performance or ad performance report, and I can click. And I will get my data instantly downloaded into my computer. So what I have done here is I have already downloaded the data, and I have played a little bit about with some of the columns because I wanted to put together the most important columns that you're going to need for this exercise. So this is my report. It has a very long salami of a lot of columns here, as you can see, and not all of these columns are important. We will only be focusing on these 5 columns here. And these are the start date, campaign ID, click URL, total spend, impressions, and clicks. Why are we doing this? Because Google Analytics 4 has a specific template which you need to use if you want to import your LinkedIn data into Google Analytics 4 so that you can have all of your ads data in one place and have standard uniform reporting for your marketing campaigns. So Google Analytics requires that you get campaign ID, campaign name, your source, your medium, date, impressions, clicks, and cost. And this template will make it available in our follow-up post, a blog post, which we're going to be publishing later this week, so that you can download it and use it. Now, for the purposes of my particular report, I need to focus on start date, which is going to be the date here. Originally, when you receive the LinkedIn data sheet, your data is going to be formatted differently. So make sure that your format matches the format required in the data column here. Then campaign ID is something very, very important if you are not using in your UTM links the campaign ID, then unfortunately you won't be able to get your data matched appropriately into your Google Analytics environment. That is why it's very important for you to start using campaign ID and adding it to your tracking links. Then your click URL is also very important because you need to add UTM parameters to your base URL. Otherwise, it's going to be very difficult for you to map your analytics clicks with what you have into LinkedIn. And I'll give you right away an example. So here is a link, and this link doesn't have any UTM parameters. What happens is I got here close to 130-140 clicks to my website from this particular ad, but because I didn't use UTM parameters, none of this is going to be registered as attributed to this particular campaign. And even if down the road some of these visitors were able to fill out a form, become a lead, or even become our customers, we will never be able to track back, you know, and attribute appropriately this particular conversion to this ad or to this campaign simply because we missed the opportunity to add our UTMs. So very, very important. Make sure you add UTM tags to all of your LinkedIn ads. This is very important, especially if you want to merge your data and build reports. The other important things that you need to make sure you do is your link here, for example, is great. It has UTM content, UTM term, campaign stage, UTM campaign, and everything else that is needed so that you can track effectively in LinkedIn your performance. So if you're not importing your LinkedIn costs and impressions and clicks data into Google Analytics, probably you're fine. But if you are importing, unless you have this important component here, UTM ID, which identifies the ID of your campaign, what's going to happen is when you import your data into Google Analytics, you are going to have a challenge. Your data is not going to be mapped effectively, and you're not going to be able to see the report what you want to see. Okay, so a couple of important things that I wanted to mention again. Number one, please make sure that you add UTM parameters to every single campaign that you run on LinkedIn. Number two, make sure you add UTM ID. It is very important if you want to see your data merge really well when you import it into Google Analytics. And number three, make sure that you focus on the template that Google Analytics provides so that your data is mapped correctly. Now, let me show you an example of how you actually export and import your data, okay? Here in your campaign manager, you select your campaigns, you export, you select the report type, and then you hit export. Once you get your data, make sure that you select the required columns here, and then you will need to break your link into the campaign name, source, and medium, and make sure that your campaign ID is the correct campaign ID associated with your LinkedIn campaign. a little bit of work, but it will all be worth it once you import your data and start getting your great reports. Now that you're ready, what you can do is you can rename it appropriately. So LinkedIn ads cost for the period of August 2023. And you can download it as a CSV file. Once it has been downloaded, you're ready to proceed to your next step. You can go to your analytics. And let me show you how you can reach this important menu here. You have to click on your admin. Admin access is required. Then you can look at your property here, and right under data settings, you have data import. Here, you can create a data source. In this case, we are going to select cost data, and I'm going to name this as PPC campaigns. Then, the neat thing is that Google Analytics 4 gives you the ability to either manually upload everything, which is a bit painful, or you can set up an SFTP option, which kind of automates things for you. It allows you to preset your template and your data with the correct mappings of your columns, and you can also decide on your schedules. This is really great because it saves a lot of time. You don't have to go through all of this manual work that I just showed you. It is automated, so the more you automate, the less time you spend and the less the propensity for errors in your data. Okay, so in this case scenario, I'm just going to do the manual CSV upload so that I can show you how it works. I am going to select my cost data, I named this, and I want to proceed with my manual CSV upload, and I can click on upload. And once I click this, I can click on my newly saved CSV file. Okay, the file has been added. Now I need to proceed to my next step, the mapping. So it is a very easy upload setup that you can experience, because everything is very neatly prepared for you. So campaign ID is the analytics field, and you can just map it to the campaign ID. And you can actually see here are the campaign IDs available. Then campaign source is going to be your source. Campaign medium is going to be your medium. Campaign name is going to be your campaign name, which is already pre-populated for you. And the date is going to be your date here. Now, daily cost, clicks, and impressions are not selected by default, so you just need to go ahead and click on them, and then you can easily map them too. So I can go here, and on daily cost, I can put cost. On daily clicks, I can put clicks. And on daily impressions, I can put impressions. And I'm ready to go. Everything has been set up in my mapping. These are my required columns, and I am ready to hit import. Once I do that, it's going to take some time before all of my data gets imported in. And for the purposes of this demonstration, I'm not going to wait until Google does that, because it might take some time. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the reports, and I'm going to show you how you can see your LinkedIn data. As soon as your report is ready, you will be able to see your report by clicking on No Google Cost. It will show you your campaigns here, and it will also show you your cost per conversion and additional cost information. But in the interim, what I'd like to do is, I would like to show you how you can get information about LinkedIn. So I'm going to come here, and I'm going to do medium. to do the session sourcing medium here. Let's give the platform a little bit of time. So I have a lot of information here. As you can see, I have 131 lines of data from so many different campaigns and sources. But what I really, really want to do is I want to find out my LinkedIn. So I'm going to put here LinkedIn. And that will immediately give me the opportunity to focus only on campaigns with LinkedIn. So here's what I can see. I can see my session campaign here, which is the LinkedIn ads, and another one, LinkedIn PPC. Then there's another one, LinkedIn PPC itself. And then under my session sourcing medium, I can see where the ads were showing. And this is pretty consistent with my LinkedIn experience because a lot of my ads here for this campaign have been showing natively on LinkedIn. But for some of my other ads, I was using the LinkedIn network of advertisers. And that is why you will see here that although this is my campaign, it was also shown on USA Today, on Yahoo, and other websites, which is kind of neat, and it shows me where my visitors came from. Once my data is imported, it will be really, really cool to see my cost here, and also my clicks here. And this will enable me to keep really, really effective and cool track of the performance of my LinkedIn ads. And we are pretty much on time. I wanted to cover again what we discussed today, how we run our LinkedIn ad campaigns. Number two, UTM tags and why they're important, especially the UTM ID or the campaign ID tag. Number three, how to download your report from LinkedIn, how to manage your data so that you can focus only on the required columns or the merge of the data between your LinkedIn and Google Analytics, how to import your LinkedIn information into Google Analytics, and where to find your report. So hopefully today's session covering these five steps to building effective LinkedIn reports in GA has been useful to you and will be helpful in your pursuit to building uniform and great reporting that improves your marketing. Thank you so much for your time. I just want to ask my assistant, Kazi, are there any questions?
It seems to be all good, Naran.
Okay. It seems that for now, there are no questions. So we are going to give you the opportunity to ask questions either by contacting us at support@campaigntracker.com or catch us on YouTube, Twitter, or LinkedIn. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful weekend. Happy tracking, and bye.
Bye, everyone.